A hose clamp made to work as a crawler on a track, a tug and a pull by a leading maxillofacial surgeon, and voila, bone can be grown. These are simple mechanical engineering principles that have been the foundation for some groundbreaking maxillofacial surgery in Cape Town. Two UCT engineers and an internationally renowned maxillofacial surgeon have teamed up to use what is known as a plate-guided distractor to grow new bone in the upper jaw of patients who had large surgical defects following an ablation of tumor or trauma. This is likely the first time the surgery has been conducted anywhere in the world. Involved have been maxillofacial surgeon Dr. Rushdi Hendricks, mechanical engineer Dr. George Vikatos from the University of Cape Town, and MSc student James Bonzai. This benchmarking surgery was performed on two patients in September and October 2011. The first was on a patient who had half her palate removed because of cancer. The second patient had the removal of an extensive tumor involving three quarters of the upper jaw and the removal of a half an eye socket and nasal cavity.
In essence, I'm trying to grow tissue, and the tissue that I'm growing is bone tissue, which gives support to your face, your facial skeleton, and also soft tissue, which is basically like your cheeks, supporting your nose, supporting the teeth in your mouth, allowing your palate to have a new vault again. Because these people have had a significant part of their top jaw removed. But it's the first time that I'm growing bone from front to back. So it's also exciting times for me to see this happening. You can have microsurgery, where one can take a piece of bone from your leg with an artery and a vein and some skin and muscle, and you can close that hole beautifully. The aesthetics has never been what one would call optimally desirable. My method is superior in the sense that I'm growing not only bone, but bone lined by keratinized lining or mucosa. So when you put your implants in, you are going to have a healthy situation. Not only that, I'm also concentrating on your smile, on the aesthetics, the way your teeth are going to sit in your mouth.
For some years, Hendricks and surgeons around the world have been applying a technique known as distraction osteogenesis to regenerate bone in the lower jaw. Distraction osteogenesis was the brainchild of Russian surgeon Gavriil Elizarov, who discovered that he could tease missing bone to regrow using what's become known as the law of tension stress.
I create a surgical fracture. In other words, I make a break. like a fractured arm or a fractured leg. And then I put the two parts together again, but I don't disturb the blood supply. And then what happens is that a blood clot forms in this fracture line, and in there are stem cells. Those stem cells have got a potential to make new types of tissue, and it can make bone, it can make muscle, it can make lining tissue, which we call epithelium.
To apply distraction osteogenesis on the upper jaw required some very special equipment, which was designed and built by Vikatos and Bonzai at UCT.
There was a device already that he was using, but it was not efficient enough. So from the engineering prospect, we had to come to a better solution to what he wanted. So after seeing his device, the devices that he was using, and the problems that they had, I came with a concept which was based on a very old principle of the hose clamp. I demonstrated on a skull. He was, of course, very concerned if that mechanism could follow a very convoluted path, if it was possible. I twisted the plate, and he could see that this could actually be an efficient way of him using it.
Now, in the case of a biomedical project, a device such as this, where you have to take into account everything from reliability, which is the fundamental engineering requirement, functionality, you know, the standard things which engineering projects involve, but then taking it further, the ergonomics of it, patient comfort, where the size of the device are fundamental, it's all about compromise, not compromise in a bad sense.
Hendrix implanted the first design into a 37-year-old patient, assisted by Vikatos, Bonsai, and dentist Dr. Yusuf Parker.
So in her particular case, I've done the operation 2 weeks ago. We applied the distractor to the bone, we screwed it all in, and we're growing the bone at 1.5 millimeters per day.
The surgery has been a resounding success, with the entire palate being filled in about a month. And in October, the team upped the ante even further. They filled a gap of an unheard of 80 millimeters in a second patient. That involved a few ergonomic modifications on the device to fit the demands of the patient's missing palate and replacing three quarters of the upper jaw. The project and the design has earned Vikatos and the team the title of South Africa's Inventor of the Year, so named by SciTech magazine, Popular Mechanics.
Me as an engineer, looking at a surgery of that caliber to reconstruct somebody's face, which not only going to have a better quality of life from talking, from breathing, from eating, from swallowing, all these functions, but also aesthetically, it is more than a sentimental value to me.
The value of this surgery lies in more than just the clever mechanics and the first-of-a-kind surgery. It also has the potential to change the entire maxillofacial surgery world and the lives of untold patients.
I've designed it in such a way that it is a DIY situation. You can take it to any situation, so that now more and more people will have access to this type of technology of closing these big holes without major surgery.